What's up, everyone? If you're looking to create your first big data application, stick around. This episode is for you. Today's episode comes from Keisha, based in Atlanta, Georgia. Keisha's a software engineer, tech instructor, active speaker, and loves all things machine learning. She's passionate about mentoring and empowering women, youth, and underrepresented groups of people in tech. Now, she wants to use her skills to shed light on income inequality. Let's hear what Keisha has to say.
I've been in the IT industry for 25 years, and I'm a strong advocate for diversity and inclusion and equity in tech. I'd like to build an app called Salary Overflow. Think Stack Overflow, but for salaries, that focuses on tech equity and uses artificial intelligence to democratize tech salaries and drive equal pay in the industry. Imagine if you had a job offer and you could pull up information to see what other software engineers like you earn at this company, or what people who aren't like you earn at this company. That would help with your salary negotiations. Or what if you could see the salary projections or predictions for people like you over the course of a career in a particular role?
Keisha wants to build an application that allows anyone to understand their salary potential and shed light on income inequality. I love what Keisha's doing here, which is one of the reasons why I had to have her story on the show. Along the way, I'll also give you tips to build the foundation for your first big data application. The first question to ask when starting a big data application is, do I have a data set? Right now, Keisha doesn't, so she'll need to build applications to collect data and then build the infrastructure to ingest and analyze it. To gather as much data as possible, I recommend that Keisha create surveys on her website and on Facebook. The mechanisms for her to collect data might change over time, but the process to prepare and analyze them will stay the same. To create a survey on her site, Keisha can use APIs created with Amazon API Gateway and AWS Lambda. API Gateway is a great service that simplifies the process of creating, managing, and securing your APIs. Lambda allows you to run code without managing servers. The responses to the survey will write to Amazon DynamoDB. DynamoDB is a NoSQL database that delivers single-digit millisecond performance at any scale. The next step is to prepare this data for analysis. AWS Glue is a fully managed service to extract, transform, and load data. Use AWS Glue to crawl your survey answer DynamoDB tables. The AWS Glue extract, transform, and load library natively supports partitions when you work with dynamic frames. Partitioning is an important technique for organizing your datasets so they can be queried efficiently. Dynamic frames represent a distributed collection of data without requiring you to specify a schema. A crawler in Glue will run through your data and do three things. One, classify your data to determine the format, schema, and any associated properties. Two, group data into tables or partitions. And three, write metadata to the data catalog. This data catalog is your single pane of everything related to extracting, transforming, and loading your data. With Glue, you can write scripts in Python or Scala, or just let Glue figure out how to crawl your data. If you don't set up the Glue crawler right the first time, don't worry. Even I got stuck with Glue the first few times I tried. The data that Glue extracts will go into Amazon S3 for analysis. In other episodes, I discussed how S3 can store front-end code and images, plus even host a static website. S3 can also store data, which is useful when you don't know its structure or you're collecting it from multiple sources. S3's unlimited storage capacity makes it great for big data applications. This architecture pattern for storing and analyzing data from multiple sources is referred to as a data lake. Now that you know what data lake means, you can feel more confident dropping this buzzword into conversations with your boss. Keisha also wants to include her Facebook survey data in her analysis. To do this, extract the Facebook survey data into a Microsoft Excel file and drop it into S3. Then, run a Glue job to extract, transform, and load this data for analysis. Now you can query and even join the two datasets with Amazon Athena. Athena combines the strength of Presto with the serverless and self-managed capabilities of AWS, a combination that rivals peanut butter and chocolate.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, so good. Oh, I need more of that. Yeah, definitely peanut butter chocolate. Mm-hmm.
Amazon Athena uses a managed data catalog to store information and schemas about the databases and tables that you create for your data stored in Amazon S3. The best place to secure access to your data lake is with AWS LakeFormation. LakeFormation provides a single view for managing all of the services of your analytics workflow, including S3 buckets, Glue jobs, and Athena tables. For those who enjoy analyzing big data with Python, I suggest using Amazon SageMaker. Amazon SageMaker is a machine learning service that allows data scientists and developers to quickly and easily train, build, and deploy machine learning models. You could take advantage of SageMaker's fully managed infrastructure to quickly run statistical Python packages like NumPy and Pandas. You'll also be set up to use SageMaker for machine learning in the future. After analyzing your data, you definitely want to share visualizations of it. To include jaw-dropping charts on your app, I recommend using Amazon QuickSight. QuickSight is a fast, cloud-powered business intelligence service that makes it easy to deliver insights. QuickSight seamlessly connects to your data in S3 or Athena. Be sure to choose Athena as your data source if you created new tables with it. Use the QuickSight JavaScript SDK to embed charts in your app. For example, you can show a chart of the top 5 cities in the US with the highest average salaries for senior software engineers broken down by gender. Keisha also wants Salary Overflow to answer specific user questions like, what do Black women software engineers earn in Atlanta? I have a job offer. Is this offer comparable to what other software engineers of the same education and experience make at this company? These specific questions can be answered by utilizing an API, just like before when Keisha created the survey with API Gateway and Lambda. The Lambda functions for this API will process requests by querying Athena and sending their response back to the front end. The results from the Athena query are stored in Amazon S3, which can be used to respond to repeat requests instead of rerunning the query. Now it's time for a recap. Collect data using Lambda and DynamoDB to survey users on your site. Next, move the response data into Glue for data transformations. The result of that transformation and all other data will land in your data lake on S3. Run queries on that data with Athena. Use QuickSight to embed charts or dashboards on your app. To integrate that data into your application, make a request to API Gateway, which will invoke Lambda to query Athena. Secure and manage workflows in your data lake with LakeFormation. That's how you build a big data application. It doesn't matter when you start or how much data you have, as long as you just get started. Thanks for hanging out with me. See you next time.